What's going on, YouTube? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and on this channel, we break down trendy music video effects and creative editing skills. And today, I could not be more stoked to be showing you guys this film roll transition that's very easy to create in Adobe Premiere Pro. But before we get started, I just want to shout out you guys out there in the audience who are watching my tutorials and leaving comments, liking the videos, all of that. The channel just hit 1,000 subscribers this week, which I am stoked about, and you guys helped me get there. So the first thing we're gonna do is basically just identify where we want the transition to start. So this is where I think a good spot for this transition is gonna be. So as you can see, we already got the two clips split in half like that. What I'm gonna do is hold shift on my keyboard, go to the left, and that's gonna bounce over 5 frames here on the left. I'm gonna make a cut right there. And now I'm gonna hit shift and go to the right twice. That's gonna go to the right 10 frames. And I'm gonna make a cut, highlight them, right click on them, and nest them so they are just one clip here on the timeline. So what we need to do first is add in an effect called offset. So that's over here in our project panel. We're just gonna type in offset, and you'll see it under the distort folder. We're gonna drag that onto our nested sequence like so. You're not gonna see anything happening here in the beginning, and that's fine. We're gonna make a keyframe under shift center 2, and we're gonna drag that keyframe to the beginning. So now what we're gonna do is scroll to the right here on our nested sequence, adjust this shift center 2. We're gonna drag this value of 540, and we're gonna just play around with this. Let's go maybe to like 5,000, okay? So it'll be a pretty quick transition here. So check this out. So you can see it right there. Maybe that's a little bit too fast. So let's take this value, let's go down to like 3,000. That's probably gonna look a little bit better. So now when I play it back, we'll get this. So that looks a lot better than how fast I had it going before. Step 2 for us is gonna be to add an effect called fast blur. So we're gonna go to our effects panel, and we're just gonna look up fast blur under obsolete. We're gonna drag that onto our nested sequence as well. And we're just gonna turn this blurriness up to about 115, right? So it gets blurry like that, but we don't want it to be blurry on the horizontal and vertical. The blur should just be horizontal, okay? So we kind of get that look. Step 3 is gonna be to add a circle. Okay, so we're gonna type in circle, and we're gonna click and drag that onto our nested sequence. So now with this circle up in our effect controls, we're gonna change the radius to like 700, right? So we get a very, very large circle here. And we're gonna go ahead and like keyframe the center and the radius points for this circle. We're just gonna keyframe and move this point around a little bit. Maybe we'll have it like kind of bleed in to the frame a little bit like that. And then maybe the radius gets a little smaller, you know, right around the middle. And then we'll go kind of like, we'll get big again. And then, you know, we'll drag the position down a little bit here from the center. And you know, it's making these keyframe points. Now when we scroll over the nested sequence, you can see how that circle is moving, right? But like, what is this circle for? Okay, so I'm gonna explain this to you guys. This is kind of an interesting way to make light leaks or film burns in Adobe Premiere Pro. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is change the color, and I'm gonna make it somewhat of an orange color. You know, something like that looks good. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna feather this outer edge a ton. We start to get this, you know, really feathered edge here with our orange circle. I'm actually gonna turn it up a little bit more. So we're gonna bring this up to even, you know, let's go to like 950, okay? Perfect. Now we got this really nice soft edge. Come down under opacity and change the blending mode to add. And now we can see our clip behind it. So now when I scroll over, we get that film burn type of look that just kind of comes into frame as the transition starts. Step 4 is gonna be to duplicate this light leak that we just made. I'm just gonna click on our circle here in our effect controls. I'm gonna hit Command C, Command V, right? So that's gonna make another circle. And as you can see, our light leak gets a little bit brighter, which is awesome. I'm just gonna change the second circle, and I'm gonna change the color to something a little more red, okay? So, you know, we get more of an authentic, fiery type of look. Now what I'm gonna do is just change the center and radius key points, the keyframes, so that it looks, it's a little bit offset from the first light leak that we created, right? So I'm gonna drag it maybe over here to the right side. And then, you know, here in the middle, we can, you know, maybe have it stay on the right side, go down a little bit. So it's kind of in the opposite corner of the orange. And then here at the end, you know, it's fine if it kind of goes across the screen a little bit, maybe a little bit less, maybe just to like the middle part. Okay, so yeah, now I keyframed that second film burn, that second circle, a little bit differently. So we have it, you know, on the other side of the frame. It doesn't look identical to our first film burn, and that just helps give it that more authentic look and feel. The effect is pretty much done. All we need to do is add in a little bit of noise, give it some texture. We're going to come over here to our effects tab, type in noise, and we're going to find it under noise and grain right here. And we're just going to throw that onto our nested sequence. As I increase it, you can see this is like very, very high percentage here, 100% noise. We don't want that. We just want something a little bit more textured than just like your normal clip, right? So we just want to add a little bit of texture in there. So I'm going to hover around 10% on this noise. You know, you can see these little noise particles here over the frame. So that just helps give it some texture, makes it look a little more authentic. So I'm just going to hit I on my keyboard to mark the endpoint, and I'm going to hit O on my keyboard to mark the out point. I'm going to come up here to sequence, and I'm going to hit render into out. This is going to pre-render what we have so far. So now you can see this green bar here on top means this sequence is fully rendered out to maximum quality. It's not going to lag at all. So now when we watch it back, check it out. Yeah, so pretty cool. One thing I would change is just how this transition starts, and I would actually easy ease out this first offset keyframe. So I'm going to right click on that keyframe, hit temporal interpolation, go to ease out right there. So now it's going to ease out of the original frame a little bit smoother. Instead of just going straight into the transition, it's going to kind of like ramp into the transition. Okay, so that's going to make it look a little bit smoother as well. And now I've rendered it so that it's full speed. So let's watch it one more time here. So yeah, so that went a little bit better with the beat right there, especially because the kick drum is kind of like off beat. So I do have a few clips here from another music video, so we're just going to go through this pretty quickly. So I'm going to start at this cut right here that hits right on this kick drum, I believe, or this bass. Yeah, so it's like the drop of the song right there. Okay, so I'm gonna go to that cut. I'm gonna hold shift, go to the left 5 frames, go to the right 10 frames. I'm gonna cut where both those clips are, right click on them, nest them so that they're their own clip. What's our first step? It's offset, right? So we're just gonna go offset, throw that on there, keyframe the shift center. We'll just throw these numbers around until we're satisfied. Let's see how fast this offset is. We're just gonna easy ease out that first keyframe, add the circle. So we'll throw that circle on there, increase our radius. Let's get really big with this one. Remember, we gotta feather it, so let's go like 1,000 feather, and let's change the color to like a red. Blending mode to add, right? Let's just drag it over here to like the left side a little bit. Let's keyframe the opacity of this one a little bit. Let's make it kind of like flicker a little bit on this one, right? So we're gonna keyframe this light leak opacity. So when I play it back now, check it out. It's not that noticeable when you watch it in full speed, but when I scroll over here, frame by frame, you can see it flickering that red. And now what we're gonna do is just throw on that blur. So let's just do Gaussian blur for this one. We'll throw on that Gaussian blur, and this time let's do vertical. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, so we're gonna keyframe the blurriness starting pretty much right in the middle of that transition. So the blurriness has got to be pretty good right away, and you know it's gonna stay pretty blurry until the motion slows down, right? So it's gonna be pretty blurry, so we're gonna make a keyframe right there, and then right here at the end it'll get like pretty much back to normal. Right, so now we got like that blur back to normal. I actually do like the vertical blur with this Gaussian blur, maybe even a little bit more than I liked the horizontal blur on my first example. Right, so there's the horizontal and there's the vertical. The vertical actually goes with the motion more for this specific film roll. And now what do we need to do? We need to add that noise, right? So we're gonna throw in that noise right on top. Turn this amount of noise up to like, you know, 20% maybe for this one. And now we kind of get that texture that makes it look a little more authentic. So pretty cool looking as I scroll over it. You know, maybe you want to add that other film burn in after all. So maybe we'll take that circle, hit Command C, Command V, change the color. You know, let's change it to like, let's change it to the orange again. You know, let's take the center over to the right side. So it's just on the right side, maybe drag it up a little bit. So it's kind of up in that top right corner. I really like it. The one thing I wish was different with this one is that if it ends pretty much on the frame of the very next shot. So you can see it kind of ends and the next frame is kind of off-centered with the next clip. So what we're gonna do is just find where that center is. So, you know, right about there, you know, that looks like it's about centered up. So maybe like right there looks good. So now we got it, and then it just kind of stops there at the end and it aligns with the next clip, right? So that's how you keyframe the offset and kind of get it to look a little smoother. Now when we watch it back. We can see what it looks like in regular motion. It's an awesome way to kind of make the beat drop slap a little bit harder. And if you're a video editor out there who's interested in adding some sauce to your edits, definitely check out my website, VentureVisuals.com. I got a free pack on there where you can try all my products completely for free. I got overlays, transitions, about to add in some overlay textures and some titles for Photoshop, some cinematic titles. I really appreciate you for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching this entire video. It means the world to me and it helps my channel grow faster. So thank you so much for that. And until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venter. Peace out.